we shall reflect on the life of Saint Chad. Born in Northumbria, England, Saint Chad was one of the four English brothers who became priests. He and his elder brother, Saint Ched, had both been educated at the great abbey of Lindisfarne on Holy Island under its founder, Abbot Saint Aidan. After the death of Saint Aidan, Chad went to Ireland. When his brother Ched was made Bishop of London, Chad acquiesced to his request to return to England to take charge of the abbey at Lustingham. When Chad himself was named Bishop of York by King Oswin, he began to devote himself to ecclesiastical truth and to purity of doctrine and consecrated a great deal on the practice of virtue. When Saint Theodore, the new Archbishop of Canterbury, arrived in England in 669, he charged Chad with being improperly ordained bishop, to which Chad humbly replied that if he felt that he wasn't properly consecrated, that he would resign the charge, of which he never thought himself to be worthy. Saint Theodore was so deeply impressed by his humility and holiness that before Chad retired to Lustingham, he made good whatever was lacking in his episcopal consecration. Soon after the death of Jaruman, the Bishop of Mercia, Saint Theodore requested King Oswin to let Chad take over that see. Though Chad shepherded the Mercians for only 2.5 years, his virtuous life made a deep impact on the people. Indeed, he is credited with the very Christianization of the ancient English kingdom of Mercia, so much so that at his death there were already 31 churches dedicated to him. A remarkable monastic founder, Saint Chad conducted his apostolate rather zealously, travelling much on foot. He died of plague, and numerous miracles have been reported at his graveside. His relics are venerated at St. Chad's Cathedral in Birmingham.